Miss Maggie. What a pleasant surprise. You look tired. I guess you'll be hitting the singles bars again. I'm sorry as for your wedding plans. Don't take it personally. I don't even know you. You were just in the wrong place at the wrong time. Well, actually, he was. Why did you come here? Well, I guess you're not much of a talker today. So I'll excuse myself. Good day.
Why?
I beg your pardon. Did you say something?
Why'd you do it? Why did you kill him?
That's a fair question. I did it because I wanted to. Any more questions?
I think you killed him for the same reason you killed everybody else. Because you couldn't kill that one man you really wanted to. Your father's already dead.
I see you've done a little research on me, Miss Mackey. God, you're so smart. Yes, my father beat me, he abused me. And now I'm dispensing my rage on every man that crossed me.
Your father beat you because you killed your mother.
It's a lie and you know it. She died giving birth to me. I didn't kill my mother.
Well, your father seemed to think so.
Yes, he did. And he died before I was old enough to realize he was wrong.
You're a pathetic little woman, Nina.
So you came here to tell me I'm pathetic?
No, I came here to tell you that you're damn lucky that these bars are between us. And you better pray it stays that way.
Well, it might not stay that way. Have you ever been in prison, Miss Mackey? I suppose not. It's very cold, very lonely, very dismal. An empty cell, a chair with no one to sit in it. Out of sheer desperation, you end up talking to yourself, holding entire conversation with no one. That's what it's like to be alone, Miss Mackey. Get used to it.
Coming out of the elevator.